haven't been myself recently.
I suffer, you know, with PTSD.
It just won't go away for a long time.
I hope that you think twice about what you are doing to this nation's veterans who are willing to die to protect this nation.
If the Army asked me to go again, to be deployed again, I would absolutely go.
I may give out, but I never give up.
In the United States, November 11th is recognized as Veterans Day. What is Veterans Day? Why is it celebrated on November 11th? In the early morning hours of November 11th, 1918, the Allied powers, which included France, Great Britain, the United States, and many others, agreed with Germany to end the fighting during World War I. Later that day, an official armistice or ceasefire was signed. In fact, the armistice was signed in Paris at 11 a.m. on November 11th of 1918, the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month. This date was almost instantly recognized as being an important one. The following year, in 1919, many nations declared November 11th a national holiday. The day became known as Armistice Day and honored those who had died during the war. Many nations still honor Armistice Day, and the focus of the holiday is placed on soldiers who have lost their lives, similar to the American holiday of Memorial Day. There are several different traditions associated with Armistice Day. For example, some nations still observe a moment of silence, usually for 2 minutes, at 11 o'clock in the morning. The first minute is said to honor the millions who died during World War I. The second minute is for the living who were also affected by the war, including wives, parents, and children. There are also significant ceremonies which take place in South Africa and Australia, as both nations were profoundly impacted by World War I. In South Africa, they observe the moment in darkness as well as silence. In Australia, instead of 11 o'clock a.m., they observe their moment of silence at 9 o'clock p.m. This is because at 9 o'clock p.m. in Australia, it is 11 o'clock a.m. in Paris. In other nations, the nature and focus of the holiday changed after the conclusion of World War II. At that point, Great Britain began referring to the day as Remembrance Day. In America, the holiday became Veterans Day. However, in the United States, Veterans Day has grown to recognize all of those who have served their country, whether living or dead, and even honors those still serving. A World War II veteran, Raymond Weeks, was the first to propose the notion of recognizing all veterans on this day. He approached Dwight Eisenhower with the idea, and it was eventually presented as a bill before Congress. Veterans Day was recognized as an official holiday on May 26, 1954. Today, Raymond Weeks is remembered by some as the father of Veterans Day. At first, Veterans Day continued to be celebrated on November 11th. However, in 1971, it was briefly moved to the fourth Monday in October. It remained on that day until 1978, when it was returned to the November 11th date. Today, Veterans Day is recognized across the United States and is observed on the 11th of November each year. Americans all over the country join with many others around the world to honor those who have served in the military.
Good morning. I am Maya Cooney, Senior Class Vice President, and we would like to welcome you to our Veterans Day ceremony. Each year, we take the time to recognize the service of veterans and honor each branch of military for their sacrifice to this country. We hope that you would take this time to reflect and honor any veteran you may know. At this time, we will now stand for the posting of the flag and the national anthem.
My name is Cadet Private First Class Jackson McCorkle. Lieutenant Colonel Kevin D. Ingraham is the senior Army instructor for the Bishop Hall Charter School and Thomas County Central High School Army JROTC programs in Thomasville. Prior to his arrival in Thomas County, Lieutenant Colonel Ingraham served as the senior Army instructor for the Ware County High School Army JROTC program in Waycross, Georgia. He retired from active federal service in October 2016. In 1996, Lieutenant Colonel Ingraham earned his bachelor's degree in business administration from Thomas University and is commissioned as a second lieutenant into the Air Defense Artillery from Florida State University. He is a 2006 graduate from the University of Georgia, earning a Master's of Education, and a 2009 graduate of Air University, earning a Master of Military Operational Art and Science. His operational assignments include platoon leader and executive officer of the 11th Air Defense Artillery Brigade, based in Fort Bliss, Texas, battery commander of the 31st Air Defense Artillery Brigade, based in Fort Bliss, Texas, Battalion S3, of the 3rd Infantry Division, based in Fort Stewart, Georgia, Brigade S3 of the 177th Armored Brigade, based in Camp Shelby, Mississippi, Battalion Commander of the 346th Air Defense Artillery, based in Camp Shelby, Mississippi, and Chief of Air and Missile Defense of the 3rd Infantry, based in Fort Stewart, Georgia. His deployments include Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, during Operations Desert Storm and Southern Watch, Awi al Salem Air Base in Kuwait, during Operations Southern Watch and Enduring Freedom, Victory Base, Baghdad, Iraq, during Operation Iraqi Freedom, COB Spelcher in Tikrit, Iraq, during Operations Iraqi Freedom and New Dawn. His military education includes the Air Defense Artillery Officer Basic and Advanced courses, the Combined Armed Services Staff School, the Total Army Instructor Course, and Air Command and Staff College. His awards and decorations include the Bronze Star with Oak Leaf Cluster, the Meritorious Service Medal with 3 Oak Leaf Clusters, the Iraq Campaign Medal with 3 Campaign Stars, the Overseas Service Ribbon with numeral 2 device, the Joint Meritorious Unit Award, the Meritorious Unit Commendation, the Army Superior Unit Award, and the Army Staff Identification Badge. Lieutenant Colonel Ingraham is originally from Cairo, Georgia, and has a son, a daughter, and a granddaughter.
On behalf of Principal Trista Jones and Superintendent Dr. Lisa Williams, I want to thank you for joining us today as we honor the service and sacrifice of the veterans of this dynamic community and extend to them a heartfelt thank you. I am Lieutenant Colonel Ingraham, Senior Army Instructor for the Thomas County's Army JROTC program. Today, 102 years ago, the guns fell silent in a war that was to end all wars. Today, we commemorate not only the end of World War I with Armistice Day on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, but we also celebrate the official recognition of this day codified by Congress and President Ford in 1975. Today is the day we turn to our veterans and say thank you. Thank you for not only serving, but for the commitment, dedication, and above all, the sacrifice to this nation. In January 1961, President John F. Kennedy spoke these famous words, "And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. My fellow citizens of the world, ask not what America would do for you, but what together we can do for the freedom of man." To all of our veterans today, I say, you answered that question. You answered that call. Your selfless service is a testimony to your courageous spirit and your untiring dedication to the defense of this nation and the preservation of liberty. You came from all walks of life. You represented all ethnicities, desperate religions, and even differing political views. Some joined for the opportunity, some for the benefits, whilst others at one time had no choice. As a military, we represent the best of America's sons and daughters and draw our strength from our diversity. Through hardship, chaos, trials, and tribulations, we honed our skills and sharpened our blade. Their stories are the story of our history because America rose to greatness on their shoulders. We owe them our very way of life, our freedom to live, work, and raise our families as we please. The very least we can do is to honor their sacrifices and thank them for all they've done for this great country. Our nation, forged in battle and tested decade after decade, has matured socially and grown economically. From that harsh winter in Valley Forge to the exhausting wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, veterans have given of themselves and endured the worst of conditions to maintain the greatest of nations. Our country has served as a beacon of hope and possibility for people around the world. Places like Verdun, Marne, Normandy, Iwo Jima, Midway, Anzio, Ardennes, Incheon, Heartbreak Ridge, Khe Sanh, Idrang, Hamburger Hill, Kafji, Medina Ridge, Fallujah, Baghdad, Nazariya, Tora Bora, Kunduz, Tarinkout, and Kandahar are etched into our history and memory. It was here that our veterans, far from home, stood shoulder to shoulder with their own, fought and even died, and forever made a difference in our world. Countless millions all over this nation worked tireless hours and long nights to ensure those we sent were trained, equipped, and prepared. The Declaration of Independence states all men are created equal, but I must disagree. There is something special, something different about a small percentage of Americans, less than 1% of the population. These men and women are unlike the rest of this nation. They possess something special inside, something so unique that they would be willing to sacrifice everything for a calling much larger than themselves. Veterans are this nation's unsung heroes. Their families and friends may have been the only ones who knew their names, who knew the sacrifices they made to serve our country. In peacetime, especially, it was easy to forget that these men and women were on duty in lonely outposts around the world. Our veterans have missed the births of their children, wedding anniversaries, and even graduations. They have spent holidays in soggy rice paddies in Vietnam, amid the stinging sands of the Iraqi desert, and in the cold and rugged mountains of Eastern Europe. Abraham Lincoln made a promise to veterans in his second inaugural address in 1865 when he said that America would care for him who shall have borne the battle and for his widow and his orphan. Our veterans have borne the cost of America's wars and have stood watch over America's peace. And today, every veteran can be certain the nation you served and the people you defended are grateful. You went when no one else would. You gave when no one else would. And you sacrificed like no one else could. We as a nation owe a debt of gratitude to each and every one of you. This day, this place, this event, this is why we are gathered today to say thank you. Without our veterans, this is not possible. Your service, your commitment, and your unwavering dedication to the ideals that make us great is why we gather today. and around this nation to simply say thank you. In his Veterans Day address at Arlington National Cemetery in 1989, General Colin Powell said, "The nation owes a great debt to its veterans, whose service to the nation spans every decade, every year, every day of a country's existence. Through untold courage and sacrifice, America's veterans have secured the liberty which the Founding Fathers sought to establish here in the New World. Whenever and wherever the nation is called, in times of darkness and danger, as well in times of peace and prosperity, America's veterans have been there. Veterans have proudly carried the torch of liberty for all to see. For most of them, their service did not end when they hung up their boots. They serve in our schools, they serve in our local government, and they serve our citizens right here in Thomasville and Thomas County. Without them, much is not possible. Our veterans remain an important part of our daily lives. As we gather this day to honor our veterans, let me close with these words. I'm reminded of these words in John 15:13. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. God bless you, God bless this school and community, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you, and go Jackets.
Four.
Go, Daddy.
Oh.
Go,
go, go.
Hi.
Go, Kevin. Kevin.
You suck! Are you serious?